I don't know what to say. I mean, yeah, if I was looking at any other team, I would be like, okay, Hoodwink, DK, good opening. But I'm looking at Lil Gun, you're going up against Army Geniuses, who seems to be in a much better shape than you are right now. And you're still, quote unquote, experimenting and trying things to improve your playstyle in different ways. I don't know, maybe they think, okay, we're just going to win against some other teams later on down the tournament, but it's coming to that point where they won't have any more games to play, and they're just losing almost every single one.
Yeah, so I feel like if they are not first phasing these heroes, they... Logan must feel like they're not that strong at the moment. I haven't...
Yeah.
I feel like Lycan is actually going to be picked up at... I feel like we're going to see it a couple times at the Major with the changes to the Helm of the Overlord and the Lycan getting buffed. So I'm very surprised Lil Gun aren't experimenting with it. Maybe they have so far and they feel like it's just not strong. That is the only read I can really make of this until I saw other teams try it, which we have seen and honestly looked pretty good. That was Polaris that picked it up. Nevermind played the Lycan. He looked decent on it. Wasn't crazy. We saw that Wolf bite on the Ursa, but we'll see. Lil Gun... Hoodwink DK, it's a very good combo. There's nothing wrong with it. It's meta through and through. Razor. But you do have to go against Army Geniuses with the Razor. And this is also another team that like to pull out the offlane Razor.
Yeah, it's always nice to have that opportunity, because now when you pick the Razor, it's pretty much a flexible pick on all three lanes, on all three cores. Very rarely played on mid lately, but you're kind of fine laning against the DK, even if it's in the mid lane. Immediately there's gonna be a Queen of Pain ban, and this Razor is already pretty safe. The thing I don't like about Army Geniuses is that they lack lockdown, but obviously they can change that down the line. They have somewhat tower push, the Pugnas don't really max out the Nether Blast any longer. It's the ward that is the primary spell. But still, this is a very tough lane to play against, and two very fast heroes. So if you get some burst on the side of Army Geniuses to start off the fight, then you have the Razor and the Pugna who can chase people down without much issues.
Yeah, is there another hero that you feel like they can pick up to help with their burst?
You're gonna go for a classic Sand King plus something, an offlaner that goes with the blink and does solid amount of magic damage. If the Sand King gets banned out, you're gonna go for a magic damage dealing mid laner, something like a Puck helps. You know, you get that first skill and then the chase is on. I already see a lot of mobility on Army Geniuses. I think that's kind of gonna be the case here, that they'll want to run around the map and search for kills.
You see Lil Gun though, at the moment, putting some emphasis on banning out some carry heroes. They're worried about the DB Medusa. I'll tell you what, I'm pretty happy that we're seeing some new carries. Again, Tiny, Dusa, not as much Templar Assassins, although TA did have a good couple of games yesterday, I believe it was. So I'm happy. We saw Tiny, of course, today twice, went 1-for-1. Haven't seen it too much otherwise. Dusa hasn't been picked up as much.
We got a troll.
We got an anti-mage. I can't remember what else we got.
We had a void. We had a void as well.
Yeah.
The ones that I'm missing are Luna, Slark, and Sven.
You're not gonna see
those
them.
Are the ones.
Yeah.
Did you just laugh at me?
Dude,
Come on.
You're not gonna see those
heroes.
There's no chance they are not getting picked up. In like an ideal Slark game, maybe. Like, okay, maybe. Luna, no one... Luna got untouched in the patch and no one was picking her up at the 7.31B, so I don't know if it's going to change. And Sven, we'll see what happens. We got a Tree and Protector though, so it's a nice way to be able to stop the Razor from getting aggressive when he has BKB. You can kind of... kite him a little bit, break the static link, and go from there. But you have to be wary of Army Geniuses grouping up very early to take towers. Tree needs some levels, and he's going to need a lineup to play early to be able to protect his own T1s.
I'm actually okay with something like a Beastmaster right now for the side of Army Geniuses. He can easily get rid of the trees. You know, and it kind of makes the treant mad when the trees are getting crushed. Plus, the Razor, you want to have some attack speed boost if you want to be able to transition into that very strong carry. But they're going to go for the Mars. I guess that's a pretty good one at taking down the trees as well. Maybe not in the early stages of the game, but you're pretty good against the Hoodwink. You're pretty good against the treant. And of course, I always emphasize how important it is when playing against the DK and these tower pushers, the DP, when they come to your tower to have a stronger teamfight. And Mars, he probably is the strongest one out of all of those, him and the Sand King right now. The Sand King needs the blink. Mars, on the other hand, he just kind of needs a level 6.
Dire team pick.
Oh, Poggers, Phoenix. I thought they were going to go Snapfire, but I'm happy with the Phoenix. Now, what's the play here for Lil Gun? I think you have to go your carry. Life, you can't life steal into Razor. Looked very good versus Mars Phoenix. I was going to say, like, Lina could be a potential, but then you put DK in an offlane. Bloodseeker. What the heck?
Okay. I don't know. I actually don't know. It's not that even that great with the tree and protector because you don't have the stun. Not good against the egg. Good at running away from the egg, but the rest of his team isn't. Remaining. I mean, when is the DK going to get the BKB and the Hoodwink and the tree, and they're not going to be able to leave the arena. Remaining. So I'm not the biggest fan of this Bloodseeker pick, I have to say. It's good to keep the Razor in place once you rupture him. But that's about it. It's not like he has a billion attack speed or something. Really, really weird pick.
I'm also in agreement. I like it at least for the reason to be able to keep the Razor in place. I think it's a pretty strong lane, true Bloodseeker. I have to imagine your other lanes. Although if you put the DK off lane, then Razor's gonna bully him, so it's not like you're gonna get the thirst movement speed there. But yeah, it's interesting. Maybe you're gonna go for someone that can really utilize the rupture and get that bleed damage if that's something you're going for. But I feel like Army Genius is now, like, you had a way to address the Phoenix in the 18th. You didn't. Now Army Geniuses can protect it, and they're not really as much with banning at the puck, but I guess it's just because they do have concerns with their stuns. But I feel like Army Genius is going to have a very, very good time in team fights, and it's a big concern for me on how Lil Gun can now take fights around that with the cooldowns.
Yeah, I mean, once the Bloodseeker gets the BKB, you can take down the egg, right? But usually the Bloodseeker, it's very hard for him to choose when to go in and out of the fight. Going in on an egg, there is a chance that you just die to the physical damage. Maybe it's the play, you know, there's an arena, an egg, the Bloodseeker pops the BKB, Treant jumps in, uses the ulti, you kill the egg, and then the fight starts off on a good note for you. You know, I'm trying to theorize around it. It can work, given that Army Geniuses don't have any BKB piercing stuns. The Bloodseeker with this first spell is still going to have enough attack speed to bring down the egg on his own. But there's the physical damage. Now if you run in towards the egg, the Lina is just going to crush your skull. So yeah. I think that Army Geniuses responded to this one perfectly.
Yeah, and now if Lil Gun wanted to try and flex the DK and go for the Lina, then that was your answer to the Supernova. It's a really good answer, I think, to the Razor, because you can outrange him and get away from the Static Link. It's also a lane dominator, so it's not like Lil Gun can play off the back of the, like, doing heavy amounts of damage mid and then giving the amp to the Bloodseeker. So I don't know. I feel like this is... What are we looking for Lil Gun? I think a position 3, so maybe. You put the DK mid?
Yeah, maybe. I'd actually be okay with them going for, like, a Snapfire. Either mid or the offlane. I feel like having the cookie to get yourself a little bit away from the Razor is fine. You're going to get the shard at some point. It's going to allow you to have that burst damage. It goes really well with the tree and protector. It would lane okay-ish against the Lina. It would lane okay-ish against the Razor, both of them. And it is also a great way to deal with the egg with a little shredder. So I'm definitely sure that the Bloodseeker, if the Lina is alive and you get close to the egg, you're dead. You're not going to have any armor items. You go for a Maelstrom BKB, then maybe you go for an armor item and...
You may now select your heroes.
Cool. That is so cool. actually. Usually the egg is a great counter to the Enigma, but right now I can just see how Lil Gun wanna fight. They have huge cooldowns, but on the other hand, so does the enemy. So what happens is you use the arena and the egg, and suddenly the Bloodseeker uses the BKB, runs towards the egg, and the Enigma catches the Lina in a black hole. So with that, you kind of win the fight. The cooldowns of the egg and the black hole, of course, the black hole a bit longer, but not by that much. You know, you can survive that one extra minute. I'm actually fine with this one. Plus, the DK will be doing okay against the Lina. I think this is the kind of lineup that Lil Gun needed to come up with to win against Army Geniuses. But still, it's not that much in the meta. It is not the greatest of lineups. It is just something that screams Lil Gun to me.
Yeah, Lil Gun always something out of left field. And I think that's what the Enigma definitely is. Here we don't see often. Some teams in Europe like to run it, but Southeast Asia, they very much avoid the Enigma. So I actually can't remember the last time I casted an Enigma game. So this is going to be exciting to watch for 11, see how they can fare. I'm a bit worried about the double range. It is, of course, something you have to do versus the Razor, but I just am intrigued on how that duo is going to shape up versus the Razor and the Pugna. I feel like Army Geniuses have very, very, very strong lanes.
They do. The thing they don't have is good supports that rotate towards the mid lane. Lina loves when her supports come towards her. Pugna and the Phoenix pretty much don't give her much. Once the DK is level 6, Hoodwink comes over. Treant, he can, but he doesn't need to. He can just assist with the living armor, and then they can actually punish the Lina or just force out the TPs on the supports, which kind of leaves the Mars and the Razor not feeling that good about themselves, especially the Razor if the black hole is ready. So if Lil Gun play this properly, if they play around the DK in the mid game with the supports, mainly the Hoodwink, and allow for there to be a delay for the Bloodseeker items, I actually see a way for them to win this one. Of course, I mean, I did give them the benefit of the doubt last time around. This time around, I'm gonna feel like it's not gonna be... I don't see them winning against Army Geniuses. I see Army Geniuses as the better team. But if there is a lineup with which they can win, this is a Lil Gun lineup kind of implemented in the current meta.
Yeah, the main thing is you see a path of victory for Lil Gun and their lineup. Yeah. So yeah, we'll see if they're able to execute. I like the point you brought up about the mid lane in particular, where Lina's not going to have supports that can help rotate to a lane, and especially to help defend the tower. Like, that's the important thing. When you've got a Dragonite who pops out a dragon form with the catapult and with the Hoodwink and Dream Protector here, Lina's not going to have anyone to stand at ground. Like, yes, you could say Lina's a great hero to be able to shove out the lane, which she definitely is, but you're very squishy, and all of a sudden, if you have a couple of heroes wrapped behind you with a slow, with a stun, you have to be perfect with clearing the way fast and getting out.
And you can see what Lil Gun did here, bringing three heroes towards the top lane. They actually expected the Army Geniuses to smoke themselves up towards the top lane so that they would clear up the woods there, so Treant Protector has nowhere to hide. With them not clearing that one up, it's actually going to make Ace's life quite a lot easier. Omi takes the rune at a cost, I have to say. Look at him, he's already half HP. So much blood.
Poor Omi. Has to tango up the walk back to the lane. See how he's able to shape up. This should be an interesting lane though, with a Bloodseeker and a Dream Protector. I think Phoenix is one of the weaker laning supports. I know he has been buffed up over time slowly with the Fire Spirits, with the Icarus Dive damage, but I think this should be a lane that Lil Gun should be favored in slightly.
Definitely, especially with the trees not being cut down. The time when there is a chance for the Phoenix and the Mars to do something is when Phoenix hits level 3. And up until then, there's already going to be a lot of regen being forced out by them. The Bloodseeker will secure pretty much every range creep with the Bloodrite. So, but still, I don't see them bullying out the Mars completely. So Womi is still going to be getting a decent amount of farm. And pretty much the point of this lane isn't to get kills. It's just to get some levels.
And actually, this is one thing I didn't think about until now, until actually seeing the interaction, but Fire Spirits is very annoying for a Tree Protector to deal with. Like, you have this huge base damage, highest in the game, but your attack speed is very low. And then on top of that, giving the Fire Spirits debuff on him makes it that much more difficult. So we'll see how Narmon's able to utilize his abilities throughout this lane, and always being a bit of a nuisance, playing away from the trees. He's got okay movement speed. I think he's got 5 disadvantage over the Tree Protector once he's out of the tree line. But we'll take a look at some of the other lanes at the moment. Is mid or bottom, you think, going to be more action-packed?
I don't think either. I think the lane that we're most likely going to be getting more action is going to be the top lane. That's where kills actually can happen if, let's say, Army Genius is overextended with their spells, and then the Bloodseeker can run him down, or if Ace overextends with his positioning and they can kill him once the Phoenix is level 3. Other than that, I think the other side lane is mostly going to be 11 trying to just get as much farm as he can, which is, of course, going to be denied a lot by DB. And Kishka just kind of fighting Varys on these poles and stuff like that. So it's not going to be too interesting. And mid lane, you know, DK can't get close to the Lina, and the Lina can't kill the DK, especially now when he's level 3. That's the potential for a kill is gone. It's just going to be a farm trade.
I think with bottom, we're probably going to see DB put more points in Plasma Field just so he can kill off the Eidolons. This is a lane that you're not going to get anything out of the static link. So just max out the Q, play the farming route. You see he's actually even already got a Lincoln's queued up, so recognizing that probably his biggest issue this game is a Blink Dragon Tail into Sharpshooter or the Rupture as well.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. The way that Lil Gun would love to start the fight is a Blink stun into a kill. Mid lane, Sanctity is low.
Yes, what's going on here? Sanctity wins the man fight and pretty comfortably as well, and you're going to see instantly Narmon wants to TP me because it was double range creeps that he wanted to try and soak some experience and the wave connecting as well. So that's a big victory for Sanctity. That was a Lina matchup. Lina usually never dies.
Imagine playing a pub and you're playing a Lina and the DK kills you. I think that the entirety of your team just starts saying really, really bad words to you. I think that's a big mistake coming out from Azura. Like, that should not happen. And of course, because this mid lane is going to be the center of attention in the early mid game once the DK is level 5, that's where the supports are going to be rotating. This is such a big deal right now for Lil Gun.
And now it gives him the first blood. Bounty, so he's got double bracer, wand, all the stats Sanctity will require. And more importantly, it's just solo experience with that kill. So he's going to get a very early level 6, maybe even before the catapult wave connects mid. So I think now for Dire, what I'm looking to see is how they set up for the supports to rotate mid.
Gonna start coming out once it's nighttime, so not before the first power rune. You want to catch the Lina there off guard when she's actually not expecting you to come, or where she's gonna be a bit greedy. Oh, DK mid lane, he can't die.
Dragon Slave up shortly. Sanctity, yo, okay, it's gonna be all right.
If he goes for this rune, he might just die. Does he have enough mana? Yeah, he does for the dragon form stun.
Yo, Sanctity playing with fire. Is there still not level 6? He's still going for it. Sanctity, what's going on? Azura's got a regen deep. What? Hang on. What's going on? 11 and Kish can kill off DB bottom.
Yep. I actually didn't expect that to happen pre-level 6, but, you know. Double pointed Malephis, the Bushwhack, and with all the Eidolons doing the damage, it is something that the Razor doesn't like playing against. He likes to be against this beefy hero that he can drain the damage from, and then just be completely fine, even if he takes half of his HP in damage. But against the Enigma, that's just never going to happen. The Eidolons are always going to be doing the damage, and that's just very nicely done coming out from Lil Gun.
They are off to a flying start. The lads on Dire. Azura's gonna find Sanctity farming in the Dragon Slave. Nicely done. Narmon gives him the tip as well. They smoke to get Azura back out. And he was able to read that perfectly with the Dragonite farming up the small camp. And that's a big, big timing. Meanwhile, Ace 12 is gonna have to TP. Azura should not be able to step in fast enough. Just shy of the LSA connecting. Very close to getting a second kill from Army Geniuses.
Man, now when you look at it, that first kill on the Lina actually worked out badly for the DK because he got super greedy, he wanted another kill, and the first Elder Dragon form did absolutely no damage to the tower or very limited damage. So now he's going to have 20 more seconds of downtime there, which means that the supports on the side of Lil'Gun, they're actually unsure when to rotate, and this allows the Phoenix to be somewhere close to the mid lane. He wants to be close to Lina, considering that's the hero that's going to be getting kills, but bottom lane, we see 11 trying to get another kill on DB. The black hole is ready.
Freeze? No, it's gonna be alright. Like you said, black hole ready. Oh, Kishka might go down, but the Skari movement speed is able to get out of harm's way. And you see, they are hesitant of playing into 11, recognizing the black hole is something that they have to fear. Bottom tower is under attack.
I don't like that Kishka isn't playing with the DK. They're trying to destroy the Razor, and the Razor in this game just isn't that big of a problem. It's not like you have a Medusa, a Lifestealer, or something along those lines. Razor, it's a Bloodseeker matchup. He's pretty much up against a race card. The Seeker can easily get himself away from the Razor. So I'd like this Hoodwink to be around the mid lane, enable the DK, and make sure that the Lina isn't doing well. Because look at this now. Army Genius is rotating towards the top lane because the Elder Dragon form isn't going to be used that well to push again.
Yeah, top lane, arena used from Wommy. He's already played with the spear, but all he was requiring was the arena to block the retreat from 4-2-3. And Narman is able to burn him to a crisp. So very nicely done. First arena, netting themselves a kill. And that was enabled as well because Azura, he shoved out mid. So there was no obligation for him to be there to defend the tower versus the Elder Dragon form. So they'd done an exceptional job to set up that rotation.
Yeah, it was perfect, and they also used the arena at the perfect time. As soon as the Bloodseeker understood that something was going his way, Sanctity? What is he doing, actually? He's not afraid of this fiery heroes. He is a Dragonite. Anyway, so he knows how to deal with fire. Ooh, bottom lane again? Yeah.
4-2-3 is going to charge in. Going to be a bit cautious right now, because Dire, they're not healthy at all. Kish is going to be killed off. Don't group up, and they do black just hole. That. But the spear, oh, Wommy, what a TP down. The instant cancel. They were waiting for the black hole to be used. They knew Wommy was coming down. The spear was waiting, and the black hole instantly taken out of the equation.
Oh, Lil'Gun, they had such a good start, and they're playing this so wrong. Play around the DK, shut down the Lina. That is the kill you want to get. That's an 1100 HP hero, and Azura, I haven't seen him been full HP for a very long time now. At least Sanctity will get some damage into the mid lane tower, but it doesn't even have to be that he's going to be taking it down, because look at this. Hoodwink is in the top lane. Kishka just isn't playing around the hero that needs some help at this point, that probably feels like he's the strongest. This is his timing, and that's even the black hole now gone. So, not looking good for the side of Lil'Gun, and it's all their fault.
They are with this, I think, third Elder Dragon form usage, getting a lot of damage on the tower, but they will not convert with it this time. It's extremely low, but it's going to have to come down to the fourth ultimate usage for them to claim it.
The next ultimate, I'm calling it the DK.
Sanctity? It's only okay, 1 point in Sunray, so yeah, he'll be alright.
The next time he uses the dragon form, there's gonna be an arena waiting for him, and he will die. So,
Sanctity might be killed off. Is there a go for this?
Might even die before that. I think not. But that was close. 3 points in Fire Spirits actually do hurt him quite a lot. As I said, next time you see the Dragon form, it's in the 40 seconds. Mars is most likely going to be ready. He has a TP ready. If you see the DK using the form, I would like Lil'Gun right now to actually read the situation and make a smoke somewhere else. Because if the Lina is there and the Mars is there, the DK will die, and it's going to be disastrous for the early game of Lil'Gun. Mars already between the bottom and the mid lane. He wants to rotate.
Oh, Wommy's gonna CB top. Okay.
That's an opening.
He's not showing at the moment is the main thing. Now with the arena drop, they're gonna get confirmation. So yeah, a bit of a window now with arena on cooldown. We'll see how they utilize this in Sanctity instantly. Elder Dragon formed up. Looking to get the last little bit of damage on the tier 1 mid. The rotations are starting to come through, but it will not be fast enough to keep the tower alive.
Okay, so the thing now is gonna be, can Lilgun use this mid lane tower that was freely given to them for sure? Trading those towers, army geniuses, I think this was a mistake coming out from Womi. So can they use this blink dagger on the Dragonite to actually get kills with the Hoodwink? And the DK, they should have enough damage to kill some of the cores. Lina probably being your main one, but Azura is approaching that BKB. He's actually not even going for the Boots of Trial first. That's interesting.
Radiant's courier has been killed.
This bottom tower is going to be difficult to siege on Lilgun, though. You've got Supernova that you can play with in the tree line, and potential TPs that are starting to come on down. 11's going to break the trees, but yeah, this is not a fight you want to take. As Naaman might just dive into the middle. He's going to do just that, dropping the Supernova, but he didn't get the Fire Spirits onto 4-2-3, and there wasn't any support to be able to act as a bodyguard as the Rupture Lane holding back Azura. Now 11's going to jump. The stuns, no, they won't be there. They have to cancel the TP on Wami's Mars, and there we go. The conversions, Lilgun, they're going to take their second tower now. Beautifully done.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. This was, you know, Army Geniuses, you could say that this might have been a mistake, but no, I think this time around it's actually Lilgun setting this up quite nicely. The Phoenix got a little bit ahead of himself there, Naaman, thinking he could get the kill, but, you know, when you see a hero that low, you're gonna go for a play. It's just how Dota works. Though, 11? He's looking dead here. If the spear connects, he just dies. Good positioning, though. He's reading the situation well on 11. I like how 11 has been playing the Enigma overall, laning stage-wise, and even now how...
DB's gonna be in trouble. Think of the blink on Sanctity. The Sharpshooter Burst as well is gonna be online. But the Life Drain! Overgrowth gonna be used to try and cancel the Life Drain. So beautifully done from Ace 12. And that will get them out of harm's way. So beautifully done. That's the reveal of the Blink Dagger. They're still in the neighborhood. Try and kill off the Pugna. There's not much Azura can really do to hold them back. Naaman's gonna try and dive into the middle. Ace 12, Duke and Jive, get out of the Sunray, and he'll do just that.
Level 1 Sunray just deals such a low amount of damage. I was actually surprised that on the top lane when they were hunting the Bloodseeker that Naaman actually was able to bring him down when he was that low. You usually feel like the Sunray is healing the enemy heroes rather than than doing the damage. So that's why the Treant got out of that one. The Living Armor region is easily gonna be protecting you from that one. So Lilgun, they're actually able to capitalize on that mid tower falling. So a few tactical mistakes coming out from Army Geniuses and it opened up the space for Lilgun. So right now what I want to see from Lilgun every single time you have the Sharpshooter, just go in and try to get those kills. It is hard, but even if you are just baiting some spells out from Army Geniuses or in their side of the map and even dying on some of the heroes, I think you're gonna be quite okay with that.
And one thing we haven't really spoken about as well is that they do not have an answer to a BKB black hole as the game goes on. I'm never relying on Supernova to be perfectly placed. That's going to be a drastic mistake from 11 if he uses it when the Nova's going to pop. So you can't really itemize for it as well. Like, there's no way to kind of deal with this. So 11 is going to be a big issue. And he's farming very well. 3-1 and 2, third in net worth. He's already got one component towards a BKB.
Lilgun are going for a play again.
Sanctity by the triangle. They're going right to Pugna, but Womi. Okay, that's a beautiful arena, but where's the follow-up? Azura's going to step inside the walls as they cut down two. The Supernova doesn't really give them much, though. Naaman didn't have the capability to dive into the middle, but nonetheless, a nice answer from Radiant as they do defend their high ground.
You're okay with this if you're a Lilgun. As I said, you're okay giving away kills in an aggressive environment. The problem is only if you're a 4-2-3, Bloodseeker dies right now. He's very fast, though the race car could be caught here. Let's see what the Mars can do.
Yeah, Womi should be able to find the spear connection. And DB, he didn't steal too much damage. Only 7, and that's going to cost them the kill, actually. Oh, no. I think the spear broke the link, so very unfortunate for them as 4-2-3 with a race car survives. And now they're on to Naaman's Phoenix. Once again, this Observer Ward. I'm really surprised because we saw prior Kishka, he was on the low ground and he took a couple of creeps away from Razor farming that exact camp. And I have to imagine, top lane 11, solo Black Hole with the Midnight Pulse. It's only level 2 Black Hole, sorry, a level 2 Midnight Pulse. But it doesn't matter, as 11. Oh, beautifully done. A gigantic solo kill for him.
A lot of things is happening here on the map. The cute thing, though, is 423, the reason he survived there, he ate the tree. He broke the tree with a quelling blade, and then the spear went onto the tree farther away, or maybe even to the cliff, and that's why the Razor's link had broken. So I'm not sure if 423 did that on purpose, or he were just randomly cutting down trees while farming. Either way, it is the thing that saved his life. Also, Lil Gun, them dying there on the aggressive is always gonna feel good, right? Now you don't want to fight. Right now the army geniuses are stronger, but I told you at the start of the draft, how do you fight here? It doesn't matter if the egg comes out. You black hole the Lina, and the Bloodseeker uses the BKB. His first spell runs in and kills the egg. He can do it at any point in the map. With them having the Enigma, they can make sure that the Lina doesn't rip apart the Bloodseeker. So I think later on down the line, Lil Gun should have the advantage in terms of fighting.
Smoke on smoke, Sanctity. Actually gonna blink to the west. We're gonna play around their own wards, but Army Genius is on the hunt. Dire's middle tower is under attack. They will not catch up. This is a big timing though for Radiant. You got the Black Hole still on cooldown for another 100 seconds, and you have BKB on Azura and DB.
And they want to fight right now for sure, and they don't want to be caught off guard like they did last time, that they lose a hero and they don't kill a core with two of their ultis being dropped. So that's why Lil Gun first, they're gonna take the tower, and now they're gonna attempt to go for a fight when they are together. So if they're the ones initiating, I think without the Black Hole, Lil Gun, they have absolutely no chance.
This Kishka is gonna get caught out in the tree line. Kishka was on some menace hours right there, pulling mid wave all the way to top, trying to be an issue. Bottom lane, hang on, they're under a ward.
Yeah, vision.
Oh, look at this. Wami drops. He doesn't have the mana for the moment. Needs to pop the soul ring, and that time expended means 423 can TP out. A slight mistake costs him the kill. Azura's gonna be forced to BKB to chase down Sanctity. Tree Protector just TPs out, and Sanctity, I don't think he can also TP because the threat of Wami being able to close the distance with the blink and spear. So at least I'll get something. Man, they're making them work for it, though, I tell you what.
Man, the footwork from the Seeker is just insane in this game. Sure, it is a fast hero, but just running circles around Womi, who didn't have the mana, and instead of first using the God's Rebuke, he went for the spear. He missed it. He thought he had it, but the Bloodseeker with the face boost just went through him. It was just an amazing play, and this is the thing. Lil Gun are forcing army geniuses to use their spells, and they're not losing anything that is that important. DK is a core, but I think in this game, you're actually fine with your DK being underleveled, with him being underfarmed, because you know that the ones that are going to be winning this game for you are the Seeker and, of course, the Enigma.
Lane. Oh, Kishka once again. Look at that percent damage. 3-point Sunray, Spirit Vessel. Nama did also go for the Spell Amp, but no Kaya. I think we were actually speaking off-screen about the Phoenix. There was a game in China, I'm pretty sure it was LGD, picked it up as a position 3 for Faith Beyond. I was just mentioning that the Phoenixes I've seen so far have been going down this Kaya first and Spell Amp as the 10 talent. But Naman's feeling like a different route is required to take this game. Dire's courier
has been killed. Yo. 11 is very close to death.
Mango that was, but Wami just picks up and eats it himself. Thank you very much.
Oh, I think 11 showed himself there with that blink. Yeah, Wami is hunting, but he, again, the spear gonna be off the mark. The thing, though, I spoke about how Lil Gun win a fight. On the other hand, Army Geniuses, they have a pretty straightforward way to win a fight as well. You find the Seeker and you open up with him, with the stun on him. I think that pretty much ensures it. If you open up with a stun on the Seeker, just egg over him. Even if there's a Black Hole, the Seeker will have to run or he will die. He will most likely die with the burst damage on the side of Army Geniuses. So 423 has to be very, very careful how he approaches this fight. It has to be the DK every single time tanking the arena, or just being the first one to initiate and give the vision to 423, who is then with the BKB. You have to run into the fight with the BKB, because if the Seeker gets stunned up, it's gonna be a really big deal.
Can they do Roche?
I guess why not? if your enemies don't want to fight, why not?
Yeah, I was just expecting the threat of all the AoE, especially the black hole in a pit, would be way too much to be concerned about, but top shoved out, mids at the halfway mark, so I'm kind of surprised they got it for free. But well, this is how you counter big team fight lineups. Like, now you sure you want to drop black hole onto the lane? Well, guess what, she'll respawn. Top lane 11.
Oh, they found 11.
Oh, the scan is going to be forced to use a BKB defensive now. So this is a window, a huge window, in fact, for Army Genius. So 70 seconds, no BKB. And Azura's going to catch out 11 on the back line. Oh, no, he popped BKB. Didn't even survive. Don't use the black hole. Oh, he thought about it. Meanwhile, mid lane, though, DB, he was killed off. I don't know how. Looks like Rupture Sharpshooter was enough to blow him up. He didn't want to use the BKB.
Dire's top tower. DK's turned into a sharpshooter. I don't know if he survives that one, to be honest. And this is a chase now from Lil Gun. They want to fight. Thank
you. They've got the egg.
Is this a good move, though?
I don't think they can fight this. They don't have. Wait. Oh, they have BKB on 4-2-3. Okay, he's going to charge in the middle. Early use of the BKB, but they won't have it for a long drawn out fight to deal with the supernova. That egg is in a perfect position away from the Bloodseeker, but Azura's still being burnt to a crisp. Sanctity with a solo kill. Now this is disastrous for Army Geniuses. They need to get out. They don't have the answers for the team fight. It's actually going to be Lil Gun that's looking to retreat. 4-2-3, trying to find an angle back into the middle.
Azura wants to fight.
And that he will. Cuts down Kishka. And a really messy fight. It looked okay, then looked bad, then looked okay, then looked kind of good.
Okay, so the heroes that are, whose BKBs are gonna be very important in terms of duration are the heroes on the Radiant side and the Bloodseeker. But I think the Bloodseeker is the most important one. The Enigma using her BKB doesn't matter. A 6 second BKB is good enough for her, especially once the refresher comes out, and that is something that 11 is looking to get. So I think he's completely fine with that one being low. But the one BKB that you want to get low if your Army Genius is the Seeker, because if you only have 6 seconds to fight for a Bloodseeker, it's a problem, especially in these team fights that could get drawn out. You know, one team kills one hero, the other team kills another with their burst, and then the fight kind of stales out. If the Seeker doesn't have a long BKB, he's going to have trouble fighting. So I don't think Lil Gun, they're going to be too happy with their trade, but still, they haven't still hit their stride. You know, so their stride is going to be when Enigma is battle ready, when they get that full 5-on-5 team fight where they're the ones initiating. So Lil Gun, I think now when the Aegis is gone, they're going to recognize that they actually have a chance to go for a 5-on-5 if they're the ones that are going in first, and that's why they're preparing for the smoke.
All right, let's see how they can take this. A couple of big levels being picked up. Sanctity 15 along with 11. They're going to charge into the middle, but Breeze, great position for the Pugnum. Eats the gank. And it'll cost him his life, of course, but you're more than truly happy with that.
Yeah, you're actually happy with that. I think both of the teams now recognize that it has finally come the time where Lil Gun want to fight.
Oh, DB?
Oh, DB is caught.
Oh, no. DB's going to get caught out. A solo black hole. It's 11. Run straight into the Razor.
DB out?
It's going to go BKB. DB out? No
He's
way.
Out.
Oh, DB. Yo. Nicely done. Okay. Oh.
I think it's battle time now for Army Geniuses. This is the opening that they were looking for. Take a fight on the top part of the map and try to focus down the tier 2 on top. That is the, I think you should go for a straight beeline there. Even if you push out Lil Gun from there, you're going to be fine.
So they're going to run into Kishka. That's the play from Bombay. They do need to deal with Dire's Observers. And as soon as I say that, Varee's going to get the one on the higher ground. There's still one around mid that also will be killed off. So there you go, Dire. They're playing with no wards now across the map. The map completely dark. So yeah, like you said, black hole on cooldown. This is definitely a window, and especially with them not being able to see anything.
A big mistake, though. The top lane is being pushed in. So the only place you can find the fight is going to be in the mid lane. But Lil Gun, I think it's more than easy for them to read this situation. You can see their positioning. They're not in a position where they can get caught.
They got Lincoln's on. Yeah, Lincoln's being delivered on the Razor. Wami's gonna jump behind the tower. I don't know. Dragonite's got BKB.
He's taking a lot of damage. You don't want to force out the BKB at the start. Now towards the backline though, 4-2-3's into the middle. A defensive supernova, 4-2-3's gonna charge and try and beat down the egg. Oh, they're able to do so. It's a perfect overgrowth. All 1-3 is raiding. They need to get out. Or maybe do they want to turn around? Wommy is gonna die in the grasp. It's raiding. Yeah, they're out of there. DB's TPing, but Azura wants to fight. They're not on the same page. DB's out. Azura wants damage. He wants blood. The BKB standing his ground, but he can't do it for long. As Dire jump on top of him, surround the leaner. 3 kills. No one dies on Logan. What a night and day difference we're seeing from the Mongolian stack.
Man, was that cool from Ace. You know, he's playing the tree and protector and he just puts out the fire there. So that's going to be helping his tree brothers for Radiant's sure. And Logan, man, this was all planned out, I have to say. Kishka, he went onto the enemy side of the map so that his teammates could push out the side lanes. So he died. He gave away his life. Then the side of Army Geniuses, they were kind of forced into this situation. It's okay, we want to fight, but the only place we can fight in is the mid lane. And Lilga, knowing where the enemies are going to come from, they're continuing to split push. And then they just rally around the mid lane, all of them together in a defensive position. And Army Geniuses, they take the bait and they die. This was set up perfectly. If this was planned out, and it, to me, it looked like it was just amazing coming out from Lilga.
Oh, no. This is not good. 11's got Arcane Rune, Ag Shard. Level 3 on Black Hole, and 8th Lens. And 8th Lens is a hell of an item on the Enigma.
Book time. Yeah, for sure.
Need a bigger
Army
fish.
Geniuses, they would probably like to put Varys in front to tank that smoke again. And we can see that he's in a perfect position. Lil' Gunner gonna get so annoyed if this happens again.
Okay. Carving his way into Raiden's territory. Smoke's gonna pop. They see Sanctity. I have a very good ward kind of towards the south of this T2 tower, so they've got to be cautious on Army G. 11! Who is in? Gets one. Azura's going to get dragged to the black hole shortly. As 11's done the damage, so they're going to try and turn it around, but Azura, he can't man fight. The Bloodseeker's got way too much damage, but Wommy, that's the angle back into this fight. Arena controlling 3 with the Sunray, but it doesn't matter. The Sanctity's on the cleanup crew. 4 heroes down. The older dragon form, they don't have an answer to. Level 20, Sanctity is now going to be amplified even more after 5 heroes have been killed off on Army Geniuses. Man, what a fight from Lilgun.
Man, I like that egg from the side of Army Geniuses, but even more, I like the Bloodseeker's decision. He was like, okay, the egg is out, but we already used our black hole. I cannot focus the egg. The Lina will kill me. He just sits on the Lina, bashes her, prevents himself from dying, and the Lina dies during that duration of the egg. It did blow up, but she got super low to a point where she could never continue fighting. That was just a huge, huge play coming out from 4-2-3, understanding who his target is. It just comes down to, if the black hole is on the Lina, I can kill the egg. If it's not, I have to sit on this Lina. And that's why he's itemizing for exactly that. The basher into a Skadi, it's gonna make Lina's damage non-existent when it comes to the right clicks.
So it's been a tough game for Azura. 5-5-4. Going Lincoln's next item, just so the rupture's not too much of an issue. But you... I mean, this blink overgrowth is the issue, though. Like, yeah, you're itemizing to deal with the Rupture, to deal with the Dragon Tail. But now the overgrowth is just going to allow the Bloodseeker to close the distance, kind of what the Rupture is doing, but you now just have another one to fulfill that role. And guess what? Black Hole's back up. Black Hole, it's back up. They can fight again.
Yeah. That was an Arcane Rune Black Hole. Yeah, you're right. They can fight it yet again, and you know, the teamfight of Lilgun, it's only gonna get stronger and stronger. I like the Razor itemized so that he cannot get picked off, but the Enigma doesn't care. He just uses the black hole there, and it just takes so long for the egg to pop. I think Narman should let go of this Wind Waker. He should let go of the Aghanim Shard and just go for that Aghanim Scepter. I think that's the play. You save a person from the black hole, you know, let's say they go on the Razor. You're going to be seeing the Seeker running towards the Lina, and then you save the Razor from the black hole. Suddenly, you have that extra core, even if the Lina dies, to do the damage and to finish off the fight.
Oh, there's no... Not again they get Roche for free. Okay, Kishka pinged it out, and they're going to send an idol on him, but it's too late. How are they getting another Roche for free?
I don't know. Especially at this point, after Lil Gun definitely understand that they're the stronger
team. No. Azura got the shard. Over Narmin.
Okay, that Yulina shard.
What?
You would give it to the Phoenix?
Yes, what are you speaking about? What's this? 10 more damage?
70 more damage per hit on the Lina that attacks 3 times per second. Come on.
No, it's spell damage, it's not right click.
It's spell damage?
Yeah, Lina's spells do 10 more damage.
Oh.
Dude, it's trash. I don't know.
It's so bad. What the hell? I actually thought it was 10 damage. You get 10 damage per fiery soul. Okay.
That would be kind of busted, I reckon. We'd see Lina. That would be OP, I thought.
I guess I need to teach myself to read yet again. I can't blame this one on the tooltip for sure. This is me.
I'd rather have DB shot on Razor instead. What? I mean, he's moving really fast. He went for the 21% Storm Surge move speed, which is kind of interesting when you reverse a Bloodseeker. Like, if you get ruptured, I know he's got Lincolns, but if he gets ruptured, then, this talent ain't gonna do much.
He's gonna die faster.
Yeah.
So he can buy back and go back into the fight, you know? Either way, go ahead.
I was going to say, we got an Octarine on Varese. This is a position 5 with a first item Octarine on a Pugna.
Okay. I guess he wants to life drain people back into health. That is actually a really good thing. If you manage to keep the Lina alive until the egg pops, that could turn the fight around for you. So having the Octarine core and always having that life drain... No, I guess going for an axe is a bit of an overkill.
Yo, get out, Wami! Let me spawn stun. And I get the vision, so he'll be able to TP out. That's beautiful. Again, Varese eats the gank. Instantly see bottom is getting pinged. Narmin's going to shove at the lane. They get the outpost. And is this a play where you think... Oh, I mean, Dire just smokes, so you can't really smoke to mid or bottom now. So what did Dire kind of do with that pickoff?
Yeah, since they don't have smokes... they just have to go back towards the mid lane. The pickoff, you're going to be happy with it just because you're delaying the Aegis. Every single time that you kill a hero, it's another minute, let's say, of the Aegis. And right now, you don't want to fight into it. I think that Lil Gun feel like in the ultra late game that they should be the winners. But I think that Army Geniuses actually have some tools to fight for that later on. Narmin wants to go for a Shiva's Guard. Please, please get that Aghanim Scepter. Radiant, I think that the Aghanim Scepter save inside of a teamfight is something that is going to catch Lil Gun off guard so many times.
I mean, one of the closest games that we've actually had over the past couple of days. They've been very much one-sided affairs. DB is farming underneath the ward, and... Oh, the spider legs. Nicely played from DB. I still might be in trouble. Blink's already been used from 11, and they're instantly beelining to bottom just in case they continue to chase DB down.
This is a good spot to catch Lil Gun in the enemy triangle to fight when you have an egg is actually quite good because there's so many ways for you to put an egg where it cannot be reached by the enemies. The Army Geniuses might be too afraid to invade the triangle right now. It is a hard place to go into, but that was a good play. I like that they forced the TPs from Lil Gun, and they could have went for a play right there and then. Just a bit scared there on Army Geniuses. I get it, though. It's 35 minutes in. If you die to a teamfight, you're gonna be forced to buy back, and then you're just one fight away of losing the game. But Ace, he's setting up this one perfectly, especially with the Aegis expiring in 50 seconds.
That's huge.
Army Geniuses. Okay, they're going to be in so much trouble. In so much trouble, especially with the rest of the team wrapping around from
they're
going
to play in the trees. Sanctity's going to stop the bat. What was that?
What?
Wami, those reactions. Now 11's in. Hits him with a black hole. They get the Phoenix as well. 11 does it. What a black hole.
ages, they'll have the second life, but it doesn't matter. The damage has been done. Second round of the black hole for 11. Clipping two. That's the way you can win the fight. One after another, they all run into the middle. They will all crumble under the damage as Lil Gun. Woo! What was that? Vision and the Enigma jumping in to take that team fight. That was beautiful. Oh, this is now a scary, scary position for the lads to be in. 9,000 net worth lead. Razor down for 50. Lena down for 40 as well. When you might be in a position where you were just speaking about Hero Freak with the buybacks potentially being forced out. I mean, T2 tower, you got the glyph up shortly, so they might be okay.
There was 5 seconds there when I lost my internet, but I saw the team fight. I didn't miss anything. I have to say, that is so unfortunate for Army Genius.
This is pouncing with a sharpshooter. Oh, the decrypt's not gonna work in his favor. Oh no, he didn't get it off. He did not get the egg off. No Narman for 100 seconds.
I mean, that was just so perfectly set up by Lil Gun. Just perfectly from start to finish. They set that one up so nicely with the wards coming out from the tree and protector. I mean, that is just Wami. A game-winning ward for sure.
Wami! Rupture up, but the BKB is soon to expire. Bree's gonna protect him for the moment. The Black Hole's on cooldown, so maybe this is a window for Army Geniuses. Double Rupture, holding Azura back, but DP. Okay, this is the first fight we're seeing Razor really have an impact. They haven't been able to cut him with a Rupture. 174 damage stolen, but now 423's on top of him. Oh no, the race car, look at him go! Kneel to the back line, but the LSA holds him. Spear pins him up against the tree. Now Azura's gonna try and stay in his ground. They might be able to kill him. Decrypt, life drain, he'll tick out. He will just tick out. He's got Spear, okay, Wami gets another. Wami gets another, but the full set of barracks have been claimed.
But meanwhile, Deathwing is destroying your tier 3 as well. So it's a tier 3 plus the full lane of racks there, plus Lil Gun have the stronger team fight. Army Geniuses, they made a few mistakes there, especially the Phoenix dieback is a big problem as well. And him, of course, Narman, just going into that black hole. I kind of feel like he doesn't play this Phoenix that much. He just Icarus dived into a black hole. It is a problem when an Enigma has a shard, and then you start diving. You know, you're going to be going into that black hole so fast, and he wasn't expecting it. So Army Geniuses, they have to make chaos around
bottom lane. They got a black hole. 11's gonna do it. Oh yeah, look at that. All the percent damage they would ever need for Wami, but it's actually not enough. Look at Wami. He's actually gonna play aggressive with the refresh up. Double arena, but he doesn't have the mana. But he does have a double BKB. 11, he doesn't want to use his own refresher. He's running outside the arena. He's gonna do it now. Looks to turn 11. No, he's hesitant. He doesn't want to use it till the last second. 11 waiting. Now he jumps. Double black hole. 11, what is he doing to them? He's got the Eidolons down. Now with the Midnight Pulse. 11, style point ticked off. My oh my, 11.
He was waiting for a bonus. Like, you're not worth two of my black holes, but oh, you and the Phoenix? Well, sure, I can do that. And he manages to take him down. And this is the thing. As I said, Army Geniuses, they need to create chaos around the map. This actually kind of goes into that category, but the thing is that their setup, that is the Mars, he's gone off the map for 60 seconds. So despite you forcing out two black holes, it is still going to be a problem, because when the Mars is back, the black holes are almost going to be up.
6,000 net worth lead for Lil Gun. They have, Jesus, a 91% probability right now. Daddy Gaben is heavily favoring the lads on Dire.
Yeah, you know, the Dota Plus, I think it works off of percentages and how many times the Dota Plus has seen a similar draft. I think 40 plus minute drafts, especially the ones that the Dota Plus is putting into consideration that, and if there's an Enigma, that team has won. So that's why it is such a big percentage right now in their favor. Though I wouldn't write off Army Geniuses just yet. There is still a chance for this Phoenix to do enough. He's still going for a Wind Waker. That is a good save, but I still think that the Aghanim Scepter is something that you should be looking towards. He probably doesn't feel like he can save anyone from the Black Hole with the Icarus Dive and the Supernova, just because how fast the Black Hole pulls him in with that Aghanim Shard and the Enigma. But the main thing is going to be the Rosh. Enigma is going to have both of his Black Holes there, and the ones that are set up with better vision are Lil Gun, but Army Geniuses, they have better positioning. They went for a smoke. The thing is, can you really find an angle? You need to come from the mid lane, I feel like. If you're going through off the river, you're gonna be in trouble.
They're ready for this. DB's charging the high ground. Lincoln's gonna be popped on the first rupture, but they got the second rupture. An early supernova. 423 is gonna try and turn to deal with this, but they don't have a way to protect it. It's 11. What is that? The black hole clipping all of them. A five man wife is Lil Gun waiting in anticipation. They spring the trap, and the tips are well deserved, as that could have been the black hole to end the game. Oh, 11.
Wait.
What?
Wait, but just how do you think, if you're Army Geniuses, that you can walk up the high ground? Like, how do you think that's gonna be happening with the Rosh is gonna be spawning? I don't know, this just seems like they were thinking that the enemies weren't ready. Like, we are fast enough, and boy was that a bad read coming out from them. But sure, nothing to take away from 11. Yep, it's game for sure. He has one more, just bless us with another black hole. We don't want to see the light ever again, it seems like.
Oh my lord. DB doesn't have buyback, so it's not like he can just throw his life away. Woo! Playing with fire, but it doesn't matter. Throne's exposed. Having fun now. DB's charging out. He knows he can't do anything. Is he going to turn his attention to the Razor? Killing off DB for the last time this game. And then throwing pops and Lil Gun. Finally able to hit the board. Again, we've been mentioning a lot how this team is needing map victories. And it's a big one to get it over Army Genius.
Yep, Lil Gun, they got the victory. The Bloodseeker actually worked out. I like the way that they played around everything that Army Genius has had. Lil Gun, they understood from start to finish what they should be doing. When they were supposed to be going for pickoffs, they were going for pickoffs. When they were supposed to be forcing out enemy ultis, they were forcing enemy ultis. And when they thought that they were stronger, they actually were, and they crushed Army Geniuses so many times over and over again. But I have to say, the biggest thing for me is that fight on the bottom lane and the setup that Lil Gun went for. Just Ace hiding in the trees there, Army Geniuses not having a sentry there. That is a huge mistake, but something that you don't expect at that point. And that fight was, I think, where the game ended, where the game broke. It was pretty much even in terms of net worth until then, and after that win, I think Army Geniuses, they felt like it was a very hard game for them to win, which it definitely was.
Man, what a game to close the night out on. That was exciting. Again, we've had some very one-sided games over the past 3 days, you and I, with our casting. But to close out the night, that's exactly a game you want to see. In the end, Lil Gun, they're able to take it. I mean, that was just... I want to see more Enigma. Come on, man. This series is exciting to watch, especially when you get a game going as long as what it did. And 11, he popped off, didn't he?
Yeah, he definitely did. He actually played the Enigma from start to finish the way he should. The only thing I didn't like from Lil Gun in this game, just I have one thing to say, is that they didn't play around the DK. Kishka was playing around 11, even though I think 11 at that point didn't need much help. But in the end, it did pay off. They got that mid lane tower in a decent timing. Army Geniuses, I think that was also a crucial time in the game, where on the fourth dragon form, they went on a play on the top lane where they killed the Hoodwink, if I'm not mistaken, and they got the tower. I think that tower trade definitely didn't benefit them, and Womi should have definitely went for Sanctity. After that one, it kind of became harder for them, but still nothing to take away from Lil Gun. They used their chances and they got a win against Army Geniuses, who I think were coming in as the favorites in this one for sure, especially with the way Lil Gun have been playing recently.
Yeah, without a doubt. So the fact that Lil Gun are able to tie the series 1-1 is going to be big for them, because again, we're speaking a lot about them being in contest with this elimination spot at the bottom. So at least being able to take a map over a team that's looking very dominant and potentially going to finish in top four is going to be big, especially morale boost for them as well. That's also what we were saying yesterday, though, when they went 1-1 against Patriots, which is definitely not a team that's going to finish top four, but just to see if that was able to build some momentum off that. So yeah, maybe past two series, they're 2-2. We'll see if they can continue the momentum from there. But we are done with that tonight. Tomorrow, we've got RSG versus Lil Gun kicking it off, Patriots versus Motivate, and then Execration versus Patriots. So that will be the... what do we got? 4, 8, 9. That's going to be the 10th day of group stages. And we have two... so we've got three more days of phase two action left. Terry Freak, is there any closing comments before we say goodnight?
Well, given that I'm done with casting the BTS Pro series, at least for now, hopefully that I'm going to get another chance if Dana goes for a trip so that we can have some fun. But overall, I had a lot of fun casting this one, and I did enjoy, so hopefully we can do this one again. Definitely nice games. We watched 9 great best of twos. As you said, some of them were one-sided, but we did see some great games, and I think this was the perfect way to close it out. Hopefully I can hold in my tears so that I can kind of retain my macho look here on stream.
Yeah, it's always been a pleasure. But yeah, like you said, we've had some exceptional best of twos, but there are three more days remaining of phase two. We still got some teams to determine who's going to be finishing in the upper bracket, lower bracket, and who will be the only team eliminated from phase two. But we will find out how everything shapes up again, starting at the same time tomorrow, 5 p.m. Singapore. We'll see you guys tomorrow for the third final day of phase two.